Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. We thank God for His mercy and grace. And today we just want to continue with our studies, amen, on the deity of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, amen. The great revelation of God becoming man, amen. The Bible says in Genesis that God created man in His own image and likeness. And the Bible says also that Adam, the first man Adam, was created in the image, in the figure of him that was to come. Speaking of the first man Adam being created in the image of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach. Amen. And we're looking at the revelation of the deity of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, amen. We just want to take a scripture reading from the book of John, amen. John chapter 3. There was a man, reading from this one, there was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. The same came to Jesus by night. Amen. Nighttime again, friends. Remember Genesis? The Bible says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. Amen. That's John chapter 1, verse 1. Amen. And then Genesis says, in Genesis 1, 1, it says, God, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. And the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. And then just forgive me, sometimes I get so caught up, you know, and I just start quoting scripture. Genesis chapter 1 verse 1. In the beginning God created the heaven and the earth. And the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. Amen. Darkness upon the earth. Water on the earth. Amen. Here you find in John chapter 3. Amen. It was nighttime. Amen. That seed of God placed in Nicodemus before the foundation of the world drove him to the light of the world, drove him into the presence of Almighty God, made manifest in the man Christ Jesus. Amen. Yes, when people looked at Jesus Christ, they saw the veil, they saw the flesh. But in the man Christ Jesus, Yahweh God, the Lord, the creator of heaven and earth, dwelt, amen. And he looked out through the very eyes that he had created in the virgin womb of Mary, amen. And he looked at his creation, Nicodemus, amen. Hallelujah. You got the picture there, amen. The creation had come to the creator, and the creator was dwelling in his own creation in a virgin born body, a body without sin. The blood that flowed in the veins of Yeshua HaMashiach, the Lord Jesus Christ, our Messiah, was sinless blood, holy blood, amen. And God, Yahweh God, the Spirit of the great eternal Father, dwelt in that body, that tabernacle of flesh. And God spoke, amen, to Nicodemus, amen. Notice verse 2, John chapter 3 says, the same came to Jesus by night and said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher come from God. Amen. So friend, the rabbis, the Pharisees, the religious people in Jerusalem, they were having conferences, they were having discussions, they were having committee meetings. They noticed there was something supernatural about the man Christ Jesus. Crowds would follow him, amen. Miracles would happen. Wherever he went, friend, there was no funeral, amen. He'd raise the dead, he healed the sick, cast out devils, lepers were cleansed, amen. One time 10 lepers were cleansed, amen. And only one returned to say, thank you, Lord. Because Jesus had said, go and show yourself to the priest as commanded by the law of Moses. Amen. And on their way, they were healed of their leprosy. And only one returned to say, I just want to thank you, Lord. Amen. I want to thank you, Lord, for healing me. I want to thank you, Lord, for delivering me from the sickness of leprosy. I couldn't face my family. I couldn't see my family. But now I can go back and embrace my family and live with my family and eat with my family. I don't have to be an outcast anymore. I just want to thank you, Lord. Amen. for healing me. Amen. And friend, we want to thank God for saving us. We want to thank God for delivering us from a devil's hell. Amen. The Bible says hell was prepared for the devil and his angels. Amen. Jesus Christ never wanted any soul to go to hell. Amen. People send themselves to hell. God sent his son, Jesus Christ, to die on the cross. Amen. So that we could have a way to go back into heaven. He is the way. He is the truth. He is the life. Won't you receive him now? Amen. The Bible says now is the day of salvation. Now is the day of deliverance. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. Here we see this man, Nicodemus. Amen. He says, no man can do these miracles without you, except God be with him. Amen. In Acts chapter 10, we read how it says, and how God anointed Jesus of Christ. How God anointed. Amen. Let's just read it. Amen. Acts 10, verse. Hallelujah. It says, how God anointed. Verse 38. Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power. Went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. Amen. Hallelujah. The Bible says that God was in Christ reconciling the world unto himself. Amen. 2 Corinthians 5:19. The Bible says to wit that God is manifest in the flesh, justified in the spirit, seen of angels, preached unto the world, received up into glory. Amen. 1 Timothy 3:16. Here we find that in John chapter 3, amen. The Bible says, Nicodemus said, no man can do these miracles without you, except God be with him. Jesus answered and said unto him, verily, verily, I say unto you, unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Friend, revelation comes when we have an honest heart. When we turn to God, then God can deal with us. Then God can speak to us. Amen. Amen. When we've got an honest heart, the Bible says, God will not despise a broken and a contrite spirit. Amen. Amen. Let me just read that scripture in 1 Timothy 3:16. I want you to be correct. Amen. And without controversy, great is the mystery of godliness. God was manifest in the flesh, justified in the spirit, seen of angels, preached unto the Gentiles, believed on in the world and received up into glory. So there was God manifest in the flesh, talking to Nicodemus, talking to his creation. Amen. And he said, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. That's why you find, friends, some people can't understand the Bible. They read the Bible and they say, I don't see nothing. It's a sealed book. Amen. Amen. And that's what the prophet Isaiah said. He said it would be a sealed book. Friend, it takes revelation. Hallelujah. You got to have an honest heart. You got to pray to God and ask God, open my understanding when I read this word. Amen. If you don't do that, friend, you will never understand the word of God. Amen. God dwells in simplicity. Amen. God reveals himself in simplicity. Amen. Hallelujah. We thank God for the end time message. Amen. Brother Branham was a great end time prophet of this generation. Amen. Hallelujah. And he preached that wonderful message. God hiding himself in simplicity. Amen. Hallelujah. So here, John chapter 3, Nicodemus, verse 4 says, Nicodemus said unto him, how can a man be born when he's old? Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born? See, Nicodemus had a carnal perception of the word. He's asking, how can a man be born again? Must I go back into my mother's womb and be born again? No, Jesus wasn't talking about that. Amen. Amen. You see, when he was born of a woman, he's subject to death. When you're born of the word, the incorruptible seed of the word of God, you're subjected to life. Amen. You pass from death unto life. Amen. We are begotten by the incorruptible seed, the word of God, which liveth and abideth forever. Amen. When you receive that word in your life, that word is full of Zoe life. That word is full of agape love. That word is full of the faith of Almighty God, the Creator. Amen. It will manifest in your life. It will take you out of darkness and put you into the kingdom of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, friend. We're going to continue in our next video. Amen. With this teaching. Amen. And we just pray that God may continue to bless you. Amen. We believe, amen, in the word of God. from Genesis to Revelation, amen. We believe, amen, that Yahweh God sent his son, Yeshua HaMashiach, the Lord Jesus Christ, into this world to redeem and save man from sin, amen. At one time the Bible says God winked at the ignorance of man, but now he commanded every man, everywhere, to repent, amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God.